Woody wrote about what he saw, you know, and wrote about the places he went, the people he met, the things he experienced. You know, Arlo has said, you know, he was a documentarian, but you know, he took it a step beyond because he would tell the story in the experience of the people whose story he was telling. You know, so the people that he met along the way, he brought them into his songs. You know, Plain Wreck at Los Gatos is a wonderful example. You never know the names of anybody in the song, but yet you feel this deep compassion for these people that are being, you know, sent away in a plane that crashes and they die. No one even knows what their names are. They're just deportees. So I guess what I would say is Woody gave us, kind of gave us license to talk about it. You know, to talk about some of the things that, you know, maybe people don't want to hear about all the time, but it's important in folk music, which you know has a broad definition. I'm not putting any kind of you know, quotation marks around it or trying to define folk music. No one's really ever been able to do that. You know, when Woody came to New York, he said he'd never heard the term folk singer or folk song. A song was just a song, and a singer was a singer. But Woody's influence has allowed us to speak our minds. You know, he's given us license to go ahead and say what we see, to not abridge that or edit it down and try to make it more palatable. But you know, we can tell it like it is, and that's a good thing to do, not something to be, you know, afraid of.